Jake.
I'm Tom.
And we are VIMTV, Velocities in Music. Today, we are going to review Anthony and the Johnsons' 2005 release entitled I Am a Bird Now. This was a request from our bi-weekly, we do a album riddle game where we put a couple of riddles out on our Twitter or Facebook, so another reason to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter, because we put these album riddles out, and you guys have to solve the album riddles. Now, whoever solves all of them correctly and emails us the answer, and whoever's first, they get carte blanche pick over an album. Mm-hmm. And so the winner of this set... requested this Anthony and the Johnsons album, which actually, I'll be the first to confess, I actually had never listened to Anthony and the Johnsons before. I am so glad that I had the opportunity to listen to this album. It is beautiful. It hit me right away in the face with just a punch of emotion and just total believable quality songwriting. You're talking really simple sound composition. Mm-hmm. Piano, Anthony's voice, which is extremely... how would you describe his voice?
It's dramatic, but not too dramatic. And it's very, you know, lots of crazy vibrato.
Passionate.
Very emotive.
Yes.
You know, it's got this kind of like old soul kind of jazz feel to it, but it's also very somber.
Yeah, and just what he's able to accomplish with the strings and other instruments that he just very minimally adds in here and there just to add color to these sound palettes is just incredible, the dynamic effect that they have. It's clear that it has influenced a ton of artists since this came out. And this is relatively recently, you know, this is 2005, not that long ago. And, you know, the first thing that came to mind is everything that is popular right now about James Blake needs to get, like, credit needs to be redirected back to Anthony and the Johnsons, because it's straight out from that. But there, I mean, aside from all of this pretty sounds that he's making and these really, you know, nice compositional pieces, you have to acknowledge that there's something bigger going on here. Would you agree, Tom?
Absolutely. And what it is to me is that this album, it tackles a lot of issues, and it does so perfectly, because not only is there the music, which is awesome,
right,
but the way it's set up. I mean, this album to me feels like a work of drama, like a play. You know, it starts out, and for the first 4.5 tracks, you know, somewhere in the middle of You Are My Sisters when the first guest spot comes in. But before that, it's just Anthony singing, and it's almost like this soliloquy from the main character of this performance that's going on, and him talking about gender issues and life and death and how you deal with the normal everyday problems that everyone has,
right,
and cope with the fact that you will die someday, going through that while still struggling with your own identity inwardly. And being able to do all that, then you come in with the guest spots, which are sprinkled throughout the last half of the album, and they're perfect guest spots. It's exactly how I want to see guest vocalists function on an album, because they don't dominate it. You still have Anthony playing a very strong and commanding role over everything. You don't feel like he's just taking a back seat to everyone, but still, it's just very strong. They supplement everything very well. Plus, just the people he chose. You have Boy George, you have Lou Reed. Who better to deal with gender identity issues,
right,
than those people?
Mm-hmm.
You know, especially like, you know, you think about Lou Reed being back in the 60s, hanging out with Andy Warhol and all those people and the Warhol superstars. And then you relate that to the album artwork and the cover being a picture of one of the transsexual Warhol superstars on their deathbed. That right there encapsulates all of the issues that this album is trying to address, and it does it so beautifully.
Uh-huh.
And the big thing to me is this. You know, you got to understand that with gender issues being a huge thing today, gender roles, homosexuality, heterosexuality, bisexuality, gender equality, regardless of sexuality or whether you're transsexual, you know, men and women being treated as equals, and transsexuals and homosexuals being treated as equals.
Right.
All these issues are exploding right now. And to tell you the truth, I'm a little distant from that.
Right.
It doesn't really relate to me as much. I've never had to struggle with those things. I still certainly empathize with the people who do. I care about them. My heart goes out to them. But regardless, it's never hit that close to home, honestly. And so for an album like this to really hit me as hard as it did and make me care and make me feel about these issues that have nothing to do with me, that is a statement. That is good music right there. That's good songwriting. That's good presentation of the music and the message you want to get across so strongly. And that's what really knocked this album out of the park for me. What really made me fall in love with it. It's like when For Today I Am a Boy coming on, and you know, this person, it sounds like, you know, kind of like this childlike character singing right. about how someday he's going to grow up into being a beautiful woman. It pulls at my heartstrings. It really right. does. It is powerful stuff. And I just realized one day while listening to it, I was like, God, this is so gorgeous and so moving. And I was like, this doesn't even have anything to do with me. I can't even relate to it. And it's still that much. I can't stress that enough.
Very well said.
Thank you.
You take all of that, which I completely mm-hmm. agree with, and couple it with this incredible control over the songwriting, mm-hmm. and then just this ability to build these tracks into these just blooming flowers. You look at the track 7, Fistful of Love, and how that, like, it just, for whatever reason, has a jazzy feel to
yeah.
it. And then kind of explodes with, like, trumpets and tenor sax.
And there's that, like, frantic electric guitar yes. going on over here.
I mean, that it's music that is ahead of its time, A, and B, is powerful from a music perspective on top of all of mm-hmm. the things that Tom said. This album is the whole shebang. It is everything we're looking for in a good album, and I gotta say, I loved it. I loved every mm-hmm. second of it. Pretty much from the first time I put it on, I was like, wow, this is something I need to pay close attention to, and the closer attention I paid to this, the more I got out of it. Mm-hmm. So, definitely highly recommend. It was a fantastic request, so thank you. I'm giving this an 88.
I'm going 88 too.
Hey, good call. It's a really good album, you guys. Mm-hmm. If you haven't heard of Antony and the Johnsons, start with this album, dive right into it, and just experience it. It's awesome. Mm-hmm. What did you guys think of this album? What's your favorite Antony and the Johnsons album, and do you have any requests? Are you interested in playing this album riddle game, and have you heard of it before? We're really trying to get people into it because it's something that's really cool for us to do. We have a lot of fun putting these riddles together because we are the biggest music nerds. And just like to sit around and solving riddles that we make for each other, which is really kind of creepy in a way, Tom.
Yeah, it's creepy.
It's a little creepy.
It's all right.
We're going to bring you into our sick little game now. So you get carte blanche requests, so make sure you follow us on Twitter and like us on Facebook. That's where we put those out. I'm Jake.
I'm Tom.
And we are VIMTV, Moving Music Critique Forward.
So it's hoping I will not drown or paralyze in life.